हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्दी। वी आर रीडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज हीट। इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव लर्नड हाउ टू यूज द थर्मोमीटर फॉर मेजरिंग बॉडी टेम्परेचर। ओके, डू यू रिमेम्बर विच टाइप ऑफ थर्मोमीटर डू वी यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द बॉडी टेम्परेचर? यस, वी यूज क्लिनिकल थर्मोमीटर। We use clinical thermometer for measuring the body temperature. But we cannot use clinical thermometer for measuring the temperature of other object. We can't use it for measuring temperature of other objects. So how we will measure the temperature of other objects? We will use a laboratory thermometer. For measuring the temperature of other objects. The laboratory thermometer consists of a glass tube. Which is sealed at one end, and having a bulb at the other end, bulb of laboratory thermometer is either filled with mercury or alcohol. Depending on whether it is an alcohol type, or mercury type laboratory thermometer. So how can we know whether it is an alcohol type laboratory thermometer or mercury type laboratory thermometer? We can know it by looking at the thermometer. The mercury appears as a gray line. If it is a mercury type thermometer, we can see the gray line of mercury. And if it is a alcohol type thermometer, we can see a red line of alcohol. An alcohol type thermometer, there will be a red line. And the laboratory thermometer generally have a range from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Its range is from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. So we can measure the temperature from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius by using laboratory thermometer. The upper end of the mercury or alcohol thread tells the temperature of the object in which the bulb of the thermometer is placed. The upper end of mercury or alcohol thread tells the temperature of the object in which the bulb of the thermometer is dipped. Suppose if we have to measure the temperature of hot water, then we will dip the bulb of thermometer in the hot water. Then we will dip the bulb of thermometer in hot water. The bulb should not touch the sides or the bottom of the container. The bulb should not touch sides or bottom of container. The shining thread of the mercury will slowly rise inside the thermometer. The shining thread will slowly rise. After some time, the thread will stop rising. Then we will read the temperature on thermometer. That will be the temperature of hot water. While reading the temperature, we should keep the bulb of the thermometer dipped in the hot water. Means we should not take it out from the hot water. It is because if the laboratory thermometer will be taken out from the hot water, then its mercury thread will start falling and we will get a wrong reading. And we will get a wrong reading. Now we will learn the precautions that we must take while using laboratory thermometer. So while using laboratory thermometer, we should hold it vertically. We should hold it vertically while measuring the temperature. The thermometer bulb should not touch the sides or bottom of the container in which the substance is taken. The bulb should not touch bottom or sides of the container. While reading the temperature, the bulb of laboratory thermometer should remain dipped in the substance whose temperature is taken. The bulb should remain dipped in substance whose temperature is being measured. Temperature is being measured. We should not hold the thermometer from its bulb and we should handle it with care, otherwise it may break. We should not hold it with the bulb and we should handle it with care, otherwise the thermometer may break. What do you think? Can we use laboratory thermometer for measuring our body temperature? No, we can't use laboratory thermometer for measuring our body temperature because as soon as we will take out the thermometer from our mouth, its mercury thread will start falling very quickly. The mercury thread will start falling very quickly. So we will get a wrong reading. We will not get the exact measurement of our body temperature. So why does the thread of clinical thermometer does not fall down when we take it out from our mouth for reading the temperature? It is because the clinical thermometer is having a sharp and narrow band. A clinical thermometer is having a sharp and narrow band near the bulb that is known as kink. The sharp and narrow band that is near the bulb is known as kink. K-I-N-K. So what is the use of this kink? This kink prevents the falling of mercury thread on its own. It prevents falling of mercury thread on its own. on its own. Nowadays, in place of mercury thermometers, digital thermometers are used. Nowadays, digital thermometers are used. The digital thermometers does not contain mercury, so they are safe for use because the mercury is a toxic or poisonous substance. There is a special type of thermometer called maximum and minimum thermometer. Maximum and minimum thermometer. These thermometers automatically record the maximum and minimum temperature of the day. They automatically records maximum and minimum temperature of the day. Temperature of the day. This maximum and minimum thermometers are used in weather forecasting. They are used in weather forecasting. So that's it for today. I hope all of you understood the topic. In case if you are having any doubt, please write it in the comment box. I will try to solve it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye and take care.